Hi there.
It's Cameron from Tinybird. In this screencast, I'll show you a basic Tinybird workflow from ingestion to endpoint creation using the command line interface instead of the browser UI. Along the way, I'll explain some of the important CLI concepts. Let's get started. The first step is to install the Tinybird CLI. There are a couple ways to do this, one of which is to mount the pre-built Docker image. But in this screencast, I'll be installing it locally using a Python virtual environment and pip. So first thing is to spin up a virtual environment and then install the Tinybird command line interface with pip install tinybird-cli. Once you've installed the Tinybird CLI, you can use tb help to access the integrated help menu with usage and a list of commands. For specific command syntax, you can use the help flag with the individual commands. To get started, you need to authenticate. Now I'm assuming you've created a Tinybird account, logged in, and created a workspace in the UI. If you haven't, go ahead and navigate to tinybird.co/signup and do that. Starting from the UI, grab your user token from the workspace where you want to authenticate. Then, in the CLI, type tb auth and then paste your token when prompted. Alternatively, you can use the token flag. Once you are authenticated, you can initialize a Tinybird data project with tb init. This creates an empty file structure and a tinyb file that stores your data project configuration. Note that the tinyb file includes your authentication tokens, so you should add it to your gitignore. Also, it's worth mentioning that if you already have an active workspace in Tinybird, you can use tb pull to download the data project files locally. In this case, we'll be working with an empty workspace. So let's create a data source. In the Tinybird Basics screencast, we created a data source from a remote CSV file containing historical stock prices. We'll do the same thing here with the CLI. Now, there are technically two ways to create a data source using the CLI. You can create a .datasource file from scratch, or you can use the tb datasource generate command. It's usually easier to use the latter, since Tinybird will automatically infer the schema from your external data source. Type tb datasource generate, and in this case, the remote file URL. This calls the Tinybird datasources API to analyze the file, infer the schema, and create the datasource file locally. You can always edit the datasource file before you push it to the server if you want to modify the schema. Now push the datasource to the server with tb push and the datasource file name. With the datasource pushed server side, you can now send data to it. Do that with tb datasource append plus the datasource name and the same remote file URL you use to infer the schema. Now, to double check that you actually have data in that datasource, you can query it directly from the CLI with a simple SQL statement using tb sql and a query. The next step is to create a pipe. As with datasources, you can create pipes using the tb pipe generate command or by creating a .pipe file from scratch using your preferred text editor. I'll create this one from scratch so you can see how that works. This is also a good place to share that we have a syntax highlighter extension for VS Code that can help when you edit Tinybird data project files. I'll create a file called newpipe.pipe in the endpoints directory, since this pipe will be published as an API. Now let's hop into VS Code to edit it. The file will have two SQL nodes. Let's start with the first one. This will return the top 10 stock symbols by trade volume. I'll call that node top10TradeVolume. Now I'll add a second node called endpoint, give it a brief description, and write some SQL to get the highest price in a year for each of the stocks returned by the prior node. You can see that I'm using the Tinybird templating language to create a query parameter. Don't worry, I'll cover more on that later. Note that you don't need to make your SQL pretty here. You can use the tb format command as soon as you're done to format your SQL automatically. With the pipe file created, you can push the pipe to the server with tb push and the file name, and the last node in the pipe will automatically be published as an API endpoint. This will also automatically create a token with read permission for the API. Bear in mind that if the pipe already exists on the server, you may need to use the force flag to override the existing pipe configuration with your new one. This helps prevent accidental pipe updates that could impact production. With the pipe pushed to the server, you can test the API endpoint. First, get the read token for that endpoint with tb pipe token read and the pipe name. Copy that token and test the endpoint with a curl command. And that's it, a simple Tinybird workflow with a CLI. Of course, there's a lot more you can do with it, and we'll go deeper on specific topics in later screencasts.